Well, Baylor wins 24-14. This was the game I've talked about all year. This is the game that kept me up at night, so to speak. This is the one. And Dave Aranda, man, his defense came to play today. They shut us down. You talk about Caleb Williams and, you know, have his hand being stepped on. Maybe that affected things. That drive near the end where they were able just to go down and score was just frustrating because, one, I think Baylor just let up a little bit. And the second time, it's like, man, I was hoping to see a couple of those drives today. But what's really frustrating about this game overall, and congrats to Baylor, you know, better team today. What's frustrating overall is that this OU defense came to play today. So whatever you want to say about this game, defense for the most part, there was a couple big plays late, but you know, at some point you can't expect your defense to win you a ball game 7-0 or 10-0. That's not going to happen, period. So Caleb had his worst game, period. So the Heisman talk, that's out the window. So I don't think I had to say that, but I'll say it just in case. But this is one of Riley's worst games. And just at some point you have to ask yourself, is it time for an offensive coordinator, for Riley to be the head man and like give the job to someone else? Is it time to I'm not calling for Riley to be fired. That's stupid. But at some point, you know, maybe you need to hand off those duties. I don't know what it is. What's also frustrating is that you're coming off a bye week. You're getting healthier, and this is the performance you put out after a bye. That makes it even worse. It's one thing if you had a really tough game the week before, and you were just drained emotionally, and it took everything out of you. You had a week off. You had a week off, and that's what really, really hits it home, that this is an awful performance. There were just times where Caleb was just missing guys wide open. I know people are going to point to some penalties here and there, and like penalties that we committed also that would stall drives. And of course, there was a period where I guess his hand wasn't, you know, he couldn't throw or get in grip, so they put Rattler in there, and he had his first play was play action, had a big play action to Mike Woods, and there was obvious pass interference, wasn't called. But rest of the time he was out there, you know, at times where he could have tucked it and run, he was unable to make it happen because he does not have the same athletic ability as Caleb Williams. So we were not able to have the best of both worlds out there when it comes to throwing the football and having a dynamic quarterback making plays. So overall, just, you know, got your butt whooped today. Not a big blowout score or anything. A 10-point loss on the road is not the end of the world to a ranked team who will now be back in the top 10 more than likely. So my question is this. Where do you go from here? Because playoff talk is on the far, far end of the back burner right now. Way in the back. So whatever happens the rest of the season happens. You control one thing. You can walk in next week to Norman. You can pout. And the crowd's like, I think the crowd showing up is going to be dead because it's going to be 11 a.m. kick. And everyone's going to be like, oh, I lost to Baylor. I've been to games like that. I know what it's like. So can you bounce back next week? At home, last home game of the year, and put together a better performance? Because it's not going to get easier, guys. It is not going to get easier. Breece Hall, Brock Purdy, Xavier Hutchinson, they come to town. And that team's got a better offense than what we just faced today. This Baylor team offensively is okay. They're not great. But they were able to do just enough because their defense smothered our offense, shut it down for the most part. There were times throughout the game where it looked like we're running the football, we're getting something going, and then it was a stall or, you know, a sack or, you know, just throwing an errant interception, just whatever it was. Every time it seemed like we got something going, shoot ourselves in the foot or Baylor makes a play. So, yeah, it's frustrating. You know, you've gone through all season, you've been fighting off all the criticisms. Like, you kept winning. Now, got a loss now. So wherever we fall on Tuesday is where we fall. And, you know, obviously there's a lot of other games to be played. Who knows how the rest of the season will turn out. But right now, all you can control is try to bounce back next Saturday and get ready for Bedlam. If you're lucky, Bedlam twice. Because right now you don't have a mulligan anymore. The mulligan is gone. So Big 12 Championship is still up there for grabs. Can you go get it? Can you bounce back? I hope they can. You know, again, this team's getting a little healthier. We'll get Theo Weiss hopefully back next week. Hopefully Caleb's hand is okay. I'm sure it was good enough for him to come back in and play, obviously, so I don't think it's that bad. But Overall, just a disappointing performance. This is one of Riley's worst coach games offensively. Just could not get anything going. Just everything just like ugh, threw up on themselves. Unacceptable. Hopefully they can go back to the drawing board and bounce back. But other than that, that's really all I got to say. Congrats, Baylor. You're a better team today. And we move to 9-1, and we'll drop in the polls a little bit tomorrow and on Tuesday. Be back tomorrow for the AP reaction. Catch y'all later.